I'll be talking about deep learning of the character set mnist. It's kind of a famous training set, and it's about 60,000 images, and they're 28 by 28, and the deep learning manages to get 97% of the images correct. And I'm going to show you a couple samplings of them, and it's really quite amazing. But if you're thinking about learning deep learning and then trying to apply it to everything, this is a good starting place. Okay, so what we start with is a part of the Keras data set is this training set called mnist. And so what we'll do is we'll just load it in and we'll get our X train and Y train. Now, this will the X train, Y train, X test, Y test. This is our beginning data set that we will work with, and we will normalize it. And then we will use the data. All right, let's get started. So we load the data set. We're going to create a 512 neuron layer, and I've added a 50 neuron or dense layer. Dense means everything is interconnected, so every node is connected to every other node. And then our input shape will be 28 by 28. Our output will be 10 different characters, and I'll show those 10 characters at the bottom. And our activation function will be softmax because we're going to do categorical classification. We'll use an optimizer. Now, originally I used the atom optimizer and I got about 89%, but I went to the RMS PROP optimizer and I got about 97%, so I like that. Categorical cross entropy, and our metrics will be accuracy. We'll use that to plot the training curve later. Okay, so what we're going to do is this X train shape of zero. This is going to tell us how many items are in there, because you will have a three-dimensional shape. So we'll have three components. We'll just grab the first component, which will be the number of items in that training set, so which would be about 60,000, which will be 60,000. And then the shape will be 28 by 28. And we'll normalize our training set by dividing by 255, because the images are grayscale from 0 to 255. Okay, we'll do the same thing with test. And now you'll notice that what we have now is this transformed train and test set. And then you can see here, here's our train count, 60,000 and 10,000 will be our test set. All right, so then what we need to do is convert the Y component, which will be the 0 through 9, into categorical data. So we can use this function, two underscore categorical by Keras. We'll do the early stop monitoring with patients of 3. What this means is if there's no improvement after 3 epochs, or three iterations, that will stop. And really, we didn't even need to do that, but I went ahead and put it in there because we're only training on 3 epochs. We could train for maybe higher to get the higher percentage improvement. But at 3 epochs, I was getting 97%, so I was happy with that. And I didn't want to have to wait too long for the training. Okay, so now we can just go through and grab 0 through 9 or 0 through 8 and for 9 items, and then we'll just plot them out. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. It's just grabbing the first just 9 items, and we can see just different numbers that are in there. So there's nothing special here. It's not showing you the possible trainings, but it's just showing 9 different items, but you can see there's 1, there's a 3, there's a 2, there's a 9, there's a 5, there's a 0, there's a 4. All right, now it's been trained. Now what we want to do is calculate the accuracy, and we know that it's 97%. We saw that one in the output in the EPIC training. And we will grab the history, which is coming back from the model itself. If you remember up here, we have history. So when it fits, it will then record the history of its training. And then we can use that to plot out our learning curve or accuracy. So here what we have the accuracy curve as it's moving towards 97%. Now we can also do the training, and we can calculate the loss. And we can also, from that loss, we can we can show how the network is converging. All right, so this is kind of the fun part. Let's go ahead and grab the predictions. So we'll pass in the test X, we'll get the predictions. Then what I'm going to do is just randomly select some of the predictions. So I will randomly grab the indice for the test X selection, and then I'll use that index to grab some different images that it was testing on. So what we have here is we predicted 5, and the actual number was a 5, so that's good. And we predicted 4, and the actual number was 4. Predicted 8, and the actual number was 8. 8 again. And this one is really interesting. Look how bad the 6 is, but it was still able to recognize that that is a 6. 4, 3, 4, 2. That one's also a really bad one, but it detected that was probably a 2 and a 1. So in the data set that I sampled, it predicted 100%. So this is truly amazing. This doesn't even use the convolution. This is all just dense network, but it shows you the power of deep learning. And so get excited about it and learn it, and get the book by Shalette called Deep Learning with Python. And he explains in more depth some of the possibilities. One of the most advanced section of the book is generative text, and that's what I'm trying to learn from this book is generative text, because I want to do summarization using the LSTM attention net node, and I also want to be able to do mechanical reasoning using deep learning.